good news. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang hapon sa inyong lahat, lalong-lalo na sa mga nakikinig sa atin sa YouTube at sa Facebook. The gospel reading that we heard today is actually composed of two parable stories. The first parable is known as the parable of the wedding feast, and the second is the parable of the wedding banquet. I'd like to say at the outset that these two parables have nothing to do with weddings. They are not about wedding receptions. They are not about getting married. They are not about wedding coordinators. In other words, this gospel is not a wedding story. They are symbolic stories. They are allegories, and they only make sense when we see what they symbolize or represent. Sana ay natatandaan pa ninyo ang ating natutunan nung tayo nasa high school, ang tinatawag na figures of speech, simile, metaphor, allegory, personification, and so on and so forth. The gospel reading today, the two parables are allegories. This gospel reading is occasionally called the parable of the rejected banquet invitation, or sometimes the parable of the disobedient guests of the banquet feasts. These two parables are narrated only in the Gospel of Matthew, and you will not read them, you will not find them in the three other Gospels. Let me say a few words about each of the two parables. In the first parable, a king invites guests to the wedding feast of his son. The king is the figure of God. The great wedding feast is a popular Jewish image for the joy of the life to come. It is about eternal life. The first parable compares the kingdom of God to a wedding feast. The king telling the guests, "Everything is ready, come to the feast." But for various reasons, dahil sa iba't ibang kadahilanan, ang mga inanyayahan hindi nakarating. The guests rejected the invitation. They declined the invitation. They ignored the invitation. They snubbed and refused the invitation because there are more important things that they have to do in life. In other words, those who were invited ignored the invitation. One of them went to his farm. The other proceeded to his business. The other was too busy working for a living. He went to his business. Busy. It is a very common excuse. Busy. Ano ang leksyon sa parable na ito? I'd like to be very brief. Alibis. Excuses. Palagi nating naririnig sa mga tao nagsasabi, "I have no time to do that. I am too busy to attend to that." Anyone will say he has no time for something that he is not interested in. Sabi nga natin sa Pilipino, kung gusto, may paraan. Subalit kung ayaw, ay maraming dahilan. Let's go to the second parable. The second parable is the parable of the wedding garment. This is related to the first parable. The man who came to the banquet came not properly dressed for the occasion. He is not prepared. The wedding garment is a symbol of repentance. The wedding garment is a symbol of the internal turning of the heart to believe in the Lord, and this invited guest faces the consequences for his lack of preparation. The wedding garment symbolizes readiness. It refers to preparedness at the last judgment for the good and the bad. Only those who are clothed in goodness will be invited to the banquet of life. Only those who deserve to enter heaven will be able to enter heaven. In other words, my dear brothers and sisters, the wedding feast represents the only important thing in life. The mistake of those who rejected the invitation is that they abandoned the important in favor of the urgent. They left the essential in favor of the contingent, neglecting the important in favor of the urgent. In our spiritual life means continually putting off or canceling or not giving attention or not giving priority to our religious and spiritual duties, because there is always something we feel is more urgent calling for our attention. I remember one of our teachers in the seminary who, although exaggeratedly, said there are Catholics, exaggeration naman ito eh, pero may point siya. There are Catholics who enter the church only 3 times during their lifetime. Number one, when they are hatch. Number two, when they are much. And number three, when they are dispatch. Hatch, binyag. Much, kasal. Dispatch, last trip, ililibing na. My dear friends, there are many other examples that we can cite. For example, it is Sunday, it is time to go to Mass, but there is that party, there is that meeting, there is that outing, there is that deadline, there is that report, there is that house to clean. Busy, busy, busy. Alibi, alibi, alibi. The Mass is dropped in favor of another activity that may actually be less important. We postpone, we procrastinate, we forget, we don't care. For example, also, it is important for anyone to go every so often to visit an older or an elderly or a sick mother or a sick father or a sick relative or friend who is living alone at home only with the helper, but we do not visit. We do not even text. We do not even call. It may be important, but it is not urgent. We postpone, we procrastinate, we delay until we forget. The danger of neglecting the important in favor of the urgent is also present in the human sphere, in everyday life. Example, the man of the house, the father, the husband, should dedicate regular time to his family. He is supposed to be with his children. He has to talk to them in order to get to know them. He has to watch them grow up. And if he can, he should play with them if they are little. But then, at the last moment, there are always urgent things to deal with in work and in the office, and he puts it off until another time, returning home too late, too tired to think about anything else. Alibis and the lamest excuses. And in the end, parents do not know their children well, and children do not know also their parents well. What is the point? We go through life choosing after the thousand little things, and we never find time for the things that are truly important, the things that impact the spiritual life and human relationships that can give real joy in our life. That is why the parables today, my dear brothers and sisters, they are like a school of life. The parables today teach us to examine and to establish our priorities, to attend to what is essential, to give priority to what is important more than to what is urgent, and to not lose the important for the sake of the urgent. Amen.